Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can build professional A-class websites faster using a tool called the Relume AI Website Builder. Now, I should mention up front that this tool isn't going to spit out a fully designed custom website for you. There are some tools that can do that, like ZipWP, which I'll cover in a future video, but that's sort of a different use case. With the Relume Builder, it's meant to be used as a tool that can improve your workflow, where you go from having a completely blank canvas to a wireframe where everything's mapped out for you. And this is especially helpful if you're building custom websites. So you can still use this if you're working on enterprise level sites, whether it's worth $10, $20, or $50,000. This isn't something where you're gonna be embarrassed at the end being like, oh, here's this website I made in 2 seconds. I've been using it for a couple months and it's actually what I use now for any new website project. So yeah, that's enough of me talking. Let's dive in and see how it works. So now we're in the sitemap builder and the first thing we're gonna do is add our company description. This is just gonna help it understand what kind of website we're building, and obviously the more information we can provide, the better. So for this example, I made up a company called PulsePay. PulsePay is a SaaS checkout platform specialized for digital products. Basically, I know a lot of people watching this are probably making websites for SaaS companies, so I figured it might be kind of relevant. But yeah, here's the company description, and then you can choose the number of pages. So if you just want a homepage, you can put one. If you want to see what kind of ideas it comes up with for pages, you can bump this up to like 10 or 15 and just see what it comes up with. I'm just gonna go with 5. So we have the core pages generated. So let's click generate. And as you can see, it's already getting to work. It's gonna, based on the company description, it actually looks at other websites and tries to figure out what pages would be most relevant. And then not only that, it also shows the sections within each page. So it's not just giving you like, oh, you should have a homepage. It's saying here are the sections that are like very highly relevant for a SaaS homepage. So you can see it has a hero header, a feature section, a bunch of them actually, testimonials, pricing, a CTA, a newsletter, a team section. So honestly, I'd say even without touching this, this is really good. And for each section, it has a description. So for the hero header, it says, introduce PulsePay with a powerful headline and a brief description of its capabilities along with a call to action. So it's actually telling you what should go within each section. This page looks pretty good to me. I'd probably just take out the team section. We don't need this. And so you can rearrange sections. Like if I wanted to put the team here. You can put this up the page if you want, or in this case, I just want to delete it. So I think this looks pretty good. And then now I just want the rest of the pages. So there's features, pricing, about us, blog posts. This looks pretty good to me. And now I'm just going to click on the other ones and I'm just going to start generating them. Yeah, it's pretty cool to see it go to work. And of course, if you don't like the results, you can click on one and have it rerun and it'll basically just take another shot at the page. So now it's done adding sections for each page. Like I said, it's all very relevant. So for example, the About Us page, it's not just repeating the same sections from the homepage. There is an about section, an awards logo list to add some credibility, the newsletter, which works here, and then introduce your key team members here. So yeah, it's all very relevant to the actual page. And then this is where the magic happens. So we have our wireframe, we have all the sections laid out, but Relume, if I haven't mentioned already, they kind of started out as like this massive Figma kit with different layouts. So for, let's say, the hero header section, they already have a ton of different layouts for hero headers. So what this is going to do now is choose a layout for basically all of these sections and build a page. So if I click on wireframe, actually, I'm just going to delete this one up here. So I'm going to click on wireframe. And now this is kind of crazy. You can see all of our pages are getting built out in real time and it's adding some sample text as well. So here's our homepage, our features, pricing, about us, blog, the blog post. I'm just going to give this a second to finish working. You can see some text just getting filled out. But I think the homepage is pretty close to being done, so let's take a look at that. And yeah, we have our hero section, and then we had a bunch of features. So feature. I can see an issue with this, so we're going to talk about this in a second. We have our testimonials, our pricing, our call to action, and our newsletter. So let's say, I wonder if I can delete it from here. I think I'd have to go back to the sitemap, but let's say I just wanted to get rid of this newsletter. It doesn't really fit in here. I can go back to our sitemap. Here's the newsletter section, and just delete this. Go back to the wireframe and it's gone. As for the text, it's really cool because it's putting in example text, so we actually know or get an idea what we could put within these sections. So simplify your digital sales with Pulse Pay is not a terrible headline. Pulse Pay is the ultimate checkout platform for digital products. Streamline your sales process, increase conversions. Like, this is actually like a very good hero section. And I think they've trained their model very well to focus on benefits, frictionless one-click payment experience. Like, it's not just talking about the product or like coming up with a random garbage. Like, this is actually very good copy without touching anything. So the problem I wanted to talk about here was, here we have an image on the left, an image on the right, and then now it repeated another image on the right, which kind of looks a little silly. So you can actually replace these sections with other sections from their Figma kit. So there's a variations of this kind of section, so we can just swap that and now have the image on the left. Or if we just wanted to change this altogether, we can, or you can change this to a video, but if we wanted to change this altogether, we can go to replace component, and you can see all their different like feature layouts right here. So we have image and then some text, but if we wanted something more, let's see here, maybe we want maybe some stats like this. Why don't we go with the stats for now? So we can choose this. It's a little different because it has some stats underneath. It actually will fill this in again. And then we want it to switch the image. So yeah, there we go. We basically made some fine tuning. And now we have a layout that we can definitely work with and just start adding our styling to. So the next step is to get this into Figma for us to add our styling. And in Figma, I opened up the Relume Figma kit, which is actually free to download. There is a pro version, but the free one is also like very, very solid. So once you're in Figma, they have a plugin called the Relume Library plugin, and we can open that and then select our project, go to our sitemap, and we're going to click add wireframe, and it's going to add all of our wireframes into Figma. So don't close the window, so I won't. And yeah, just a few seconds later, it's done adding all of our wireframes. So all the pages are loaded in. Here we can see our home page. I totally forgot. I probably should have. Let's see if I can just copy this over. So I'm going to exit that, and I'm just going to make a new page called wireframes. That way it's a bit more organized, and yeah, have our wireframes here. And the really nice thing about this too is that everything is connected to the Figma kit styles. So let's say for this H1, it'd be kind of annoying to have to change the font or the font size for all of the pages. So here it's connected to the Figma style. We can edit this H1. Let's say we want to change the font to, let's say we want to go with DM Sans. So we can change that. Bold is cool. And yeah, it changed the font here, but also the font here. Basically all the H1s now use the new font. If we want to change the buttons, we can go to find the main component. So we'll just click on that. And then here, so here's kind of like the Figma kit style guide with the typography, our different headings, our colors and our UI elements. So I want to change the color of this button. So I'm going to click on the button. Let's just go to the parent here. And then I want to change the color of the button. So I'm going to detach this. I'm going to change it to, let's pick a bluey, maybe more bright like this, maybe a little more purpley. Okay, let's end up with that. Obviously I should make these as a new style. So I'm gonna add this as a new style, call it primary. Create, and we're gonna make our border the same. Sometimes it's good just to add the same color border so you can have outline style buttons. But yeah, so here's our button. I'm gonna change the font to maybe be a semi-bold. And then we want to add some rounded corners to this. So we're going to, let's see, add maybe 6. Actually, yeah, let's stick with 6 for now. So this is our new primary button. And if we go back to our wireframes, you can see that we now have our new buttons. So yeah, it's pretty cool that it takes in all of the styling from our styling guide and applies it to the wireframes that we imported from the AI builder. Here's a quick example of what you can get it to look like with just a few minutes of work. This layout's a little bit different because I did it before making this video. But yeah, this honestly took me no more than 10 minutes. I just added some gradients, styled the buttons, and added some fonts and stuff, put in an image here. And I mean, this for, I don't know, 10 minutes of work looks pretty dang good, right? So that's just the power of being able to have this layout and then just quickly add some styling to it. The final step is to, of course, build the website in your builder of choice. If you're using Webflow, then Relume actually has a Webflow integration, so you can export all of those layouts directly into Webflow. You're still gonna have to apply your styling, but you don't have to build each layout from scratch, so that'll save a lot of time. If you're using WordPress and maybe you're using Quickly or Bricks Builder or something, you're gonna have to build all of the sections from scratch. But because you have the design fully spec'd out, it's not gonna take you that long. And you have the style guide so that you have consistent spacing and typography and everything. And especially if you're using a framework like ACSS or Core Framework, then that'll just be streamlined even faster for you. And lastly, if you're using Framer, obviously Framer is fairly interchangeable with Figma, so you can just use the Framer plugin, import it into Framer. You might have to clean a couple things up, but I'm not even sure if you would, because it's all using auto layout and everything, obviously. So you'll be pretty close to a final version, even just straight from Figma. All right, let's talk about pricing really quick. This could change depending on when you're seeing this video, but right now they have a free plan. Mostly this is gonna get you the Figma kit. You can kind of play around with the site builder, but you only get one project. This is actually improved. Before, you could only use a sitemap builder. It looks like you can possibly use the wireframe kit. I'm not 100% sure, but if you did want to have 3 projects, unlimited AI usage, export the wireframe to Figma, this is the plan I'd recommend. So it's $32 a month if you get it yearly. If you do it monthly, it's $38. Totally worth it if you are building a website, because this is going to save you hours and hours of time. So unless you're charging $10 an hour or less, then this is totally worth it. And you could also just do the monthly. And if you have one project, just sign up for this for a month and cancel it after you're done. And then the pro plan will just kind of give you more team members to your plan. So similar features, just more team members and unlimited projects. I should also mention that the Relume team graciously hooked up the New Pulse community with a coupon code. So if you are looking to save a little bit of money, then you can use the coupon code in the description below and sign up for one of the plans for a little bit less, which is always nice. So that's it for this one. Like I mentioned, the Relume AI Site Builder is an amazing tool to have in your tool belt, especially if you're building custom websites. And I can't really think of a reason you wouldn't want to use it. It's basically what I'm using now to start any new website project. If you're looking for an AI Site Builder that does the design as well, those are slowly starting to pop up. I'll have my review of ZipWP shortly, but in my opinion, those are different use cases. ZipWP is more for kind of like starter sites and proof of concept. The Relume AI Site Builder is if you're building those $10, $20, $50,000 websites where it needs to be a custom design, you want to be heavily involved in the process, then I think that's where this really shines. Anyways, that's it for this video. Check out the coupon code in the description below. It is an affiliate link. You don't have to use it, but it would help support the channel. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.